Hi, I'm Bob DeToma. I'm standing on the shores of Walden Pond in historic Concord, Massachusetts. It's a beautiful day in March. The sun is shining. We're going to walk the trails, take a look at the countryside, and look into the life and times of Henry David Thoreau. Day trip to history starts now. Hi, I'm Bob DeToma. Thank you for joining me once again on Day Trip to History, here today at Walden Pond. I'm unfamiliar with Mr. Thoreau, but in the process of doing my homework for this project, I realized that he and I share a number of common ideas. Small government, limited taxation, and a minimalist lifestyle. So as we explore the grounds today, we'll look at those three topics and see how they relate to him and how they relate to things today. Stay with us.
Thoreau came to Walden on the 4th of July in 1845 with a heavy heart. The love of his life had refused his marriage proposal, and he had endured the tragic and untimely deaths of his brother John and Emerson's younger son. He writes in Walden, "I went to the woods because I wished to live deliberately, to front only the essential facts of life and see if I could not learn what it had to teach, and not, when I came to die, discover that I had not lived."
Thoreau's cabin is an exercise in recycling. All of the materials were taken from other buildings that were torn down in the area. The cost of the building was approximately $28. It's a 10 by 15 foot structure. Recently, I traveled to Japan and became familiar with the Japanese culture of minimalism. It turns out that Thoreau was a big believer in minimalism. The interior of the cabin is decorated with three chairs, his writing desk, the fireplace wood stove, and his bed.
Thank you. Our lives are frittered away by detail. Simplicity, simplicity, simplicity. I say let your affairs be as two or three, and not 100 or 1,000. Instead of 1,000,000, count 6, and keep your accounts on your thumbnail. A man is rich in proportion to the number of things which he can afford to let alone.
Henry David Thoreau was an American author, poet, naturalist, a tax resister. He was a surveyor, a historian, and a philosopher.
What is the good of having a nice house without a decent planet to put it on?
Henry David Thoreau was a lifelong abolitionist, and he often delivered lectures attacking the fugitive slave law and defending John Brown.
How does it become a man to behave toward this American government today? I answer that he cannot without disgrace be associated with it. I cannot for an instant recognize that political organization as my government, which is the slaves. America is said to be the arena on which the battle of freedom is to be fought. But surely it cannot be freedom in a merely political sense that it is meant. Do we call this the land of the free? What is it to be free from King George and continue the slaves of King Prejudice? What is it to be born free and not to live free? What is the value of any political freedom but as a means to moral freedom?